He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
Okay, so for today's problem, we've got this compound here with a carbonyl and a methyl group, and our target molecule has the methyl and a bromo group, and what we want to be able to do is figure out how to get from here to here in two steps. Give it a shot. So as we're analyzing this, let's take a look at the molecule. We're realizing that we have to lose oxygen. We have to figure out a way to get that oxygen atom off of there. And we also have to figure out a way to get a bromine atom on there. And so we have two steps to play with. Either one's going to get rid of the oxygen, one's going to add the bromine, or somehow both are going to happen at once. But what we definitely want to do is get rid of that oxygen. So we don't really know of a way to remove a carbonyl oxygen, so why don't we reduce it? Let's take sodium borohydride, just a nice soft reducing agent, and let's, as step one, reduce that carbonyl. We're going to get an alcohol. Now that we have an alcohol, we have some different possibilities to think about. Now, one possibility that we might want to use is some strong acid to protonate that hydroxyl group, get it to leave, right, as a water molecule. So but then what we want to do is choose a strong acid selectively that might perform the other transformation that we also want to occur. So why don't we use hydrobromic acid and see what happens? Well, so once again, the first step was that we had some hydride, and that went ahead and reduced it. So here is our alcohol. Now if we use hydrobromic acid, we're going to get that right there. So the hydroxyl has been protonated. Now water is a good leaving group. We are in acidic conditions, so carbocations are going to be fine. So that can go ahead and leave. Now the interesting thing here is if we have a secondary carbocation, remember that a secondary carbocation that is adjacent to a tertiary or quaternary carbon, you're probably going to get some kind of hydride or methanide shift. And so what's happening here is we've got this implied hydrogen, and what we can do is it'll spontaneously just do a hydride shift. And so if this hydride moves over there, that's going to neutralize that carbocation. It's going to leave a carbocation at the tertiary position. Once again, this happens because a tertiary carbocation is more stable than a secondary carbocation. So that is going to happen spontaneously and pretty much instantly. And now, since we used hydrobromic acid, when this deprotonated, it's going to leave a lot of bromide swimming around in solution. And so that's going to kill two birds with one stone, because if there's a lot of bromide and it finds this carbocation, it is absolutely going to react and generate the intended product. So because we were clever in the selection of acid, we've been able to induce this in two steps. The first thing we did was reduce that ketone to the alcohol, and then because we used HBr, we were able to get that water to leave, allow this carbocation rearrangement to occur spontaneously, and then the free bromide ions that were swimming around in solution find the carbocations, and there you go, we get our product. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.